Congress is returning to Washington after a two-week recess. Democrats and Biden administration officials say their top priority is passing an infrastructure package. But Alexandra Limon reports lawmakers will also have to deal with the crisis at the U.S.-Mexico border. Alexandra?
Good evening, and this week, Democrats would like to keep the focus on President Biden's newly unveiled infrastructure package.
Well, the American people already know that our infrastructure needs a lot of work.
Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg says the public, including Republicans, support the plan, which he says will create millions of jobs by rebuilding highways, bridges, and mass transit. And Speaker Nancy Pelosi says workforce development, child care, and affordable housing are all critical parts of the package, too.
So it's physical infrastructure, it's also human infrastructure.
President Biden has invited Democrats and Republicans to the White House Monday to ask them to support his $2 trillion infrastructure plan.
This is a massive social welfare spending program combined with a massive tax increase.
Among those invited, Senator Roger Wicker of Mississippi.
We're willing to negotiate a much smaller package.
The sort of big, bold, utopian, European-style socialism proposal that they've laid out there is something they can try and do another time.
Republicans like South Dakota Senator John Thune say the infrastructure package is too expensive, and they want to shift the focus to the situation at the border.
I think, you know, restore funding to build a wall.
The president says he's willing to make some changes to the plan to get Republicans on board, but he's threatening to push the bill through with only Democratic support if that's what it takes. Reporting in Washington, Alexandra Limon.